Harshida and Chaudhry. She is like MD family medicine. She will more focus on the family thing, like with kids and with elders, how you take care of your family in this situation.
My name is Harshida Chaudhry and I'm a family physician. So today I will be speaking more about kids because I get a lot of questions from parents that they hear that kids seem to get the milder illness. So that's what I wanted to talk about more. So usually, yes, all the studies that are conducted in China and across the nation, more 94 to 95% of kids, they get either mild or asymptomatic illness, meaning they either have very mild symptoms or they don't show any symptoms at all. But there are 4 to 5% of kids who would still get the severe illness to need to be hospitalized. And those kids are the ones who have underlying health problems, like kids with asthma, kids with cystic fibrosis, the kids who have type 1 diabetes. So those immunocompromised kids, they still will get as severe illness as some of our older folks are getting. Also, the newborns and infants, they seem to be at higher risk. Because newborn and infant, અને newborn અને infant નો મતલબ કે ભઈ નવા જન્મેલા બાળકો કે જે 12 મહિનાથી નાનું બાળક હોય એને infant કહેવાય. Because their lungs are very immature, એ લોકોને ભી serious illness થવાના chances બહુ વધારે છે. બાકીના જે kids છે, it seems like they get very mild or asymptomatic illness. અને એના માટે અમુક theories બહાર આવી છે કે ભઈ એવું કેમ, kids ને કેમ mild illness થાય છે. તો એ થિયરીમાં એક થિયરી એવી છે કે જે આ વાયરસનું પ્રોટીન છે જે આપણા હ્યુમનના સેલના રિસેપ્ટર જોડે બાઇન્ડ થાય છે અને પછી એ રીતે આપણા સેલમાં એન્ટ્રી મેળવે વાયરસ અને પછી ધ વાયરસ રેપ્લિકેટ્સ અને એકમાંથી હજાર ને હજારમાંથી મિલિયનમાં રેપ્લિકેટ થઈ અને આપણને ડિઝીઝ કરે. તો કિડ્સમાં એ જે રિસેપ્ટર હોય છે હજી એટલા મેચ્યોર નથી હોતા. So that is the one theory કે કિડ્સમાં એટલું બધું વાયરસનું રેપ્લિકેશન નથી થઈ શકતું બીકોઝ ધોઝ રિસેપ્ટર્સ ઓન ધ સેલ્સ આર નોટ મેચ્યોર યટ. અને અનધર થિયરી દેટ હેઝ કેમ આઉટ ઇઝ કે ભાઈ કિડ્સના લંગ જનરલી હેલ્ધી હોય કમ્પેર ટુ એડલ્ટ લંગ બીકોઝ એડલ્ટ લંગ હેવ બીન થ્રુ સો મેની ઓફ પોલ્યુશન, એક્સપોઝર, સ્મોકિંગ. સો કમ્પેરેટિવલી કિડ્સ લંગ્સ આર હેલ્ધીયર. સો દેટ ઇઝ ઇન ધીસ ઓલ બેડ ન્યૂઝ, એટલીસ્ટ દેર ઇઝ સમ ગુડ ન્યૂઝ that if your kid does not have any underlying health problem, they are less likely to develop the severe illness. But that doesn't mean that we don't take precautions. We still take all the precautions, but at least that is reassuring. Now, I also hear a lot of questions about, so what if one of the family member have COVID-19? So if you live in a joint family, meaning you have your parents with you, which are older, you have your little kids with you, and then one of the member gets diagnosed. So as the other doctors previously mentioned, the person with the COVID-19 stays in isolation. But what if it's a little kid? What if the little kid has corona? How are you going to put that little kid in isolation? So in that case, the mother will be still taking care of the kid with taking all the precautions. So like she will wear the mask. She can make the kid wear the mask if the kid is old enough to understand. But if the kid is infant or newborn, then you cannot make the kid do the precautions. You have to take as much precautions as you can take. Like mother will still breastfeed the baby, but wear the mask, wash her hands frequently. Also the other people in the house, like the elderly parents and all that, they will avoid as much contact as possible with the kid. Also, it's even if not the kid, an adult person in the house has COVID-19, keep your parents very separately. If you have a big enough house, they should stay in a separate room and not come in direct contact you at all if possible, because those are the people who are dying, the elderly people with diabetes, high blood pressure, because of their age, their lungs are poor as well. So those are the people where we hear more death rate currently. So it's very important to keep your parents in a separate area of the house if possible. Also, they mention a lot about cleaning and all that. I wanted to mention few more points. It's also very important to clean your doorknobs, your remote control, because we are sitting at home watching TV all the time. So we touch our remote control so many times. So the remote control sanitize with at least 70% alcohol, your cell phones. Sanitize your cell phones with 70% alcohol as well. There is not everybody who can stay at home. There are still some people who have to go to work every day, like healthcare workers or people who work in a public sector, like people who work at grocery stores and all that. They still have to go to work every day. So my advice for those people is, as soon as you come home, before you touch anything or even touch your kids, go straight to the bathroom, take a hot shower, throw those clothes for the washing and wear a clean, neat, new clothes. So that way, then you can touch your kids or touch any other things in your house. But the first thing is to take a shower. Even if you are just coming from grocery shopping, still just go for a shower, change those clothes and wear new clothes. That will significantly reduce your risk. And then, like I said, clean the all the surfaces, doorknobs, your remote control, your cell phones. One little thing, I know I'm taking more time. Just one another thing before we move on to next doctor is pregnant woman. So there are not a lot of studies yet for us to know the risk to the unborn child. So yes, pregnant woman can get the infection like any other person, but we still don't know what are the implications on the unborn child. So again, for her too, my advice is to stay safe and follow all the precautions. But luckily, both azithromycin and chloroquine are safe during pregnancy. So even if a pregnant woman end up getting the infection, at least we have some hope that we can cure her with those medicines, because both are considered safe during pregnancy. But like Dr. Thakkar said, it's always prevention is better than cure. So obviously you have to follow all the preventive measures. And then again, if after that someone ends up getting it, there are some treatments that are coming out.